feel the earth move under my feet. I feel the sky tumbling down. Let's do that again.
I feel the earth move under my feet. I feel the sky tumbling down.
You're sounding wonderful.
Thank you so much for joining us tonight for this celebration of wonderful original music. The album Blue and the album Tapestry, released in 1971. You're gonna hear stories about these iconic albums and artists throughout the evening as we perform the songs.
That's right. And the other thing we should say tonight, you've got it already. I had a note that I had to say to you, that there are rules tonight. There's a rule to this performance. And the rule is that singing along with us is obligatory.
Yes.
But it sounds like you've already got that. So this is a big community sing-along. These songs are in our DNA. And even if you've never heard them before, you'll find they are just the thing you want to sing on a hot summer's night.
Yeah, exactly. Right?
So we're going to work through a lot of the different songs of Carole King and Joni Mitchell. And the next song we're going to do has got a kind of a local link to it.
It does.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is a song called Carey. It's a Joni Mitchell song. And we're going to interpret the songs a little bit. It's not going to be like on the album. We want to have fun with these songs. But I want to mention to you that the character in this song, there was an article in the Washington Post a couple of years ago about him. And the actual character who's mentioned, Carey, was a man called Carey Reditz. And the reason there was an article in the Washington Post was Carey Reditz resurfaced after all of these years. He was the guy who was living in a cave in Greece. And Joni Mitchell, when she went to escape the rat race and her career and everything, went off to Greece, and she lived in a cave with Carey Reditz for a little while. He was the red rogue, who we'll hear about later on in another Joni Mitchell song, California. But he reappeared in all places in Silver Spring, Maryland.
That's where he lives now.
That's where he lives. So there's a whole article, you can find it on the Washington Post if you Google it, and he turned up in what, after he'd had his hippie, he was the archetypal hippie guy, the red beard, the, you know, turning his back on all the societal norms, living in a cave, and he then went into, he became an economist. Development economics, and if you're in development economics, where are you going to live but Washington, D.C. for the World Bank? And so that's his story. I think he's just retired recently, but he went from being the red rogue in a cave to a Silver Spring development economist hippie.
As you do.
This is the song, Carrie.
My clean white linen, my fancy French cologne.
get out, you can
get out your cane.
I'll put on some silver. You're a mean old daddy, but I like you. Thank you so, so much.
So we're going to jump around a little bit from Joni Mitchell to Carole King. And when you think about Carole King, a lot of people say, well, 1971 was when she appeared in people's consciousness with the album Tapestry. But of course, if you've seen the play Broadway, the Carole King,
Beautiful,
which was the Broadway play. It's a lot of words I've got to say here, you know, just bear with me on this. You'll realize that she had a whole career as a songwriter, as a musician, way before Tapestry. So in the 1950s, she was writing songs for bands like the Drifters, the Platters, and all of the girl bands, the Shirelles, and the Chiffons, and all of these great songs. She also had a high school boyfriend at the time called
Neil Sedaka.
And you may remember Neil Sedaka did a song which went, "Oh, Carole, I am but a fool." And that was about
Didn't Carole write a song called "Oh, Neil"?
She did. She replied with "Oh, Neil" after that. But a lot of the songs that she wrote were for people like the Monkees. She did Pleasant Valley Sunday was a song she wrote for the Monkees in the 1960s, as well as all these great 50s hits. And Dusty Springfield. She was writing big hits for Dusty Springfield. Yeah. So she had this massive career. And then what happened in 1971 was moving away from the pop songs of the era, she started to explore her own reality in these songs of Tapestry. Yeah. And a lot of the time it was songs which were very sensitive and very intimate and very personal. And that's the kind of area, because this changed music. And we'll talk a little bit more about that later. But this is a song she did, a beautiful one called Far Away. This is definitely one for singing along to.
Let me introduce my wonderful band, Karine Chapdelaine on bass. Manny Arciniega on percussion. Amy Barmé on keyboards and vocals. And of course, Ken Avis on guitar and vocals.
This is a debut at Lubber Run for the other three members of the band.
Is it so?
Yeah.
This is your first time at Lubber Run? Wow, yeah. Awesome. Welcome to Lubber Run, guys. Well, you're going to get to hear Amy sing one of Joni Mitchell's wonderful, wonderful tune, California. Oh, is that it? Is that the next song?
Let's do it.
Okay,
that
let's do it.
That sounds great.
Somehow they have different notes than I do.
I lived in California for a while, and my husband got really sick of songs where people would sing California. And then I was like, well, it's Joni Mitchell's fault, you know.
And she's Canadian.
So she's Canadian, you know. They love the sun.
Blame Canadians, you know. Blame Canada.
Always blame Canada.
Blame Canada.
Okay. We'll do that one next. Blame Canada.
I've got to not do this too fast, right?
Yeah.
Got it. I'd say that's fast.
Okay.
Yeah. Is that good?
Okay.
Is that good?
Let's do it there.
So lonely
Amy Bormann.
Thank you so much.
You may think that's not quite like the way Joni did it, and it's because we had this idea, if you think back to the 60s, the Who were kicking around as well. And we came up with that riff as a way to play it. That wasn't 1971. The strange thing is about 1971, and the reason we started this project was we realized that it was one of the main years for changing the face of popular music. And the number of songs we've played where we've looked it up now and said, when was that song released? So we were doing Just My Imagination by The Temptations. I was convinced it was a 1960s song. 1971. Marvin Gaye, What's Going On? 1971. Stairway to Heaven by Led Zeppelin.
No.
1971. These are true facts. True facts. So the remarkable thing about these two albums, when they were being recorded, they were recorded in the same building. They were in A&M Studios in Los Angeles, 1971. They were recorded at exactly the same time. It took 1 week to record each album. And A&M Studios had three recording studios in the building. So Joni Mitchell was in one studio. Carole King was in the studio next door. There was a third studio just below, and that's where the Carpenters were recording their first album for A&M. But just around the corner, about 200 yards around the corner, James Taylor was recording Mudslide Slim and The Blue Horizon in 1971 as well. And as you may remember, James Taylor was one of the beaux of Joni Mitchell, so she was kind of getting over that relationship. A lot of the sensitive lyrics were related to that. But the next song we're going to do was one of the biggest songs off Carole King's album. And the interesting thing was these musicians would just go to each of the studios and sit in. And if you look at the liner notes, you'll see they were each doing harmonies on each other's records, and they were playing on each other's record. And as the recording session was coming to an end, James Taylor approached Carole King and said, "Carole, I really like that song you do. You've Got a Friend. Can I record that on my album?" And she said, "Sure, James, no problem." So he recorded a version of this, and you'll probably think this is really a James Taylor song because he was the first person to release it in September 1971. And it went straight into the charts, did really great in the charts. But just a few weeks later, Carole King released it, and it went to number one in the charts and stayed up there for like 17 weeks. And just to make the story local to Arlington, the same year, just down the street here, Roberta Flack was a musician from Arlington. And Roberta Flack was recording some albums and some singles with Donny Hathaway, so she did a version of this song as well. And that also went into the top 20. So this one song, three times it hits the charts.
That's amazing.
It went on to get the Grammy for Best Vocal Performance for James Taylor. It got the Best Song of the Year for Carole King, and it was the first time a woman had ever won that Grammy. Mm. So this was a big deal. And the album Tapestry went on to win four Grammys in 1971, just to give you a sense of how big that album was and so many of these songs that you recognize from the album. So this is the James Taylor song. What was it, the Carole King song? Who knows?
Carole King, Ken. When you're down and lonely, and you need some love and and think of me, and soon I'll know. Over here, you're gonna sing "Ain't It Good to Know" with Amy, and we're gonna answer with "You Got a Friend."
Ain't it good to know?
You got a friend.
Ain't it good to know?
You got a friend.
Ain't it good to know?
You
Wow, you sound awesome.
Oh, nothing like Lubber Run on a Saturday night in July, is there really?
I know.
This is the place to be.
This is just a special place, very special place. We're so lucky to be all out here with you. It's not raining. It's not that sticky. So a beautiful Joni Mitchell song, which was not supposed to be a holiday tune. But somehow, although it's a real, real sad-ass tune, it ended up being a holiday favorite on some people's playlists, so it's called River.
Remember, it's only 6 months to the holidays. And we do have this on our holiday CD, which is available for sale tonight. Lynn Veronneau on vocals.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Back with Carole King this time, right?
Back with Carole. Yeah. Carole always had this beautiful thing of putting gospel into her songs, this beautiful gospel feel. And quite unexpected for a Jewish girl from New York to do that. But she did it so, so well. And here's one where we get to hear a big gospel piano opening from Amy Bormett over there on the piano. I love this song. This is Way Over Yonder, so get ready to harmonize.
Oh,
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, so another great Carol King song. So the thing that happened in 1971, all through the 60s, music had been very dominated by men. Don't know how that happens. Sometimes it happens. Sometimes a bit of a boys' club. A bit of a crash over there. And, you know, we had Janis Joplin and so on, and Joni Mitchell was already doing music in the folk field, but popular music was so male-dominated. And what changed in 1971 was with these two specific albums, all of a sudden, the themes had changed. It was no longer teenage songs. It was adult, grown-up songs, songs about sensitivity, songs about life. And it was women's songs. It was songs which spoke specifically to women and women's issues.
Let me jump in right here, speaking
yes.
of...
I'm a mansplaining. Damn.
So Ken is our historian. He actually lectures in music history, but this is not a lecture. but yet, the what happens is that all of a sudden these women who had been writing, lots and lots of songs for other people, for themselves, all of a sudden are adopting a different narrative. And they're owning their own stories. They're telling their own stories in their own words. And it changes the landscape of American music, where not only the stage is now very female, but the audience all of a sudden becomes very female too. And yes.
Some of you may have gone to see Carole King
right.
with your mums. Because mums and daughters were going to these shows.
It reaches across generation, and although the songs are, they're songs of their times, you know, they're a lot about love and lust and longing. They just become very personal, and a brand new era of American music starts.
Okay.
I'm done.
You're done. And this song, which really features our wonderful Manny here on the percussion, is a song which Carole King got to number one for 4 months, and it stayed on the chart for 6 years. 6 years on the charts. Exactly. Let's go.
Okay, I'll start.
Thank you.
times again for me and you. But we just can't stay together, don't you feel it too? Still I'm glad for what we had, how I once loved you. But it's too late, baby, now it's too late. No, we really did try to make it. Something inside is dying and I can't hide and I just can't fake it. Oh, oh, oh darling, it's too late. Thank you so much. You're just wonderful. I like that. That was sweet. I love that. Oh my goodness. So we love to play with these songs. We love to transform them when we can and fun things or just a little more soulful things, right?
So we've done a lot of Carole King songs tonight. It's time for a trilogy. We're going to do a trilogy of Joni Mitchell songs.
Are we now?
Right now. At the time that she did this album, Joni Mitchell said, you know, I had no defenses at that stage in my life, no defenses. I couldn't hide, I couldn't pretend. And she described herself as being just like a clear cellophane wrapper on a cigarette packet.
Wow.
And that's what comes out in the lyrics of these songs.
So Joni Mitchell was performing at the Newport Folk Festival just this past weekend. It's amazing, absolutely amazing. She's all over YouTube, check it out, that's fabulous. So wonderful to see her out again.
Still be on my feet.
time you told me love is touching souls, and surely you touch mine, 'cause these lines pour out of me here from time to time. Still be on my feet. I met a woman, she had a mouth like yours. She knew your life, she knew devils and your deeds. And she said, go to him, stay with him if you can, but be prepared to bleed. Oh, you're on my bloodline, holy wine, you taste so bitter and so sweet. I could drink a case of water.
Veronneau.
Another beautiful song about travel, longing for home, longing for a connection. This time, song by Amy Borme on keys too.
All I really want, all I really want.
wanna talk to you. I wanna shampoo you. I wanna renew you again and again. Applause, applause. Life is our cause. When I think of your kisses, my mind sees. Do you see? Do you see? Do you see how you hurt me, baby? And I hurt you.
How's everyone doing tonight? How you doing, Ken? You good? You know, I've been to sea before. Crown and anchor me. Oh, let me sail away. Hey, blue, there is a song. Underneath the skin, an empty space to fill. Well, there's so everybody's saying that hell's the hippest way to go. I don't think so, but I'm gonna take a look around though. And blue, foggy lullaby. There is your song for me.
Lynn Veronneau, Amy Bormet, Blue. So I mentioned all those songs from the 50s and the early 60s that Carole King wrote. This was one. Big hit for the Chiffons.
Tonight your mind completely, you give your love so sweetly. Tonight the light of love is in your eyes. Will you love me tomorrow? Can I beautiful voices. Thank you. Thank you so much. Wow. Well, I think we've come to the end of our show.
We have. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Arlington Arts, for organizing these amazing concerts. The summer is full of great music in Arlington. Thank you. Thank you to the wonderful staff who are managing sound and lights and even backstage here. Jody and Marcus, thank you so much.
We are going to do this song. I'm not lecturing, I promise.
I was just going to ask you, actually, to just, you know, draw them in.
Just kind of draw it up and summarize and facilitate the end of the evening. Yes? Oh, absolutely. So, again, these wonderful musicians, it is the first time that Amy and Karine and Manny have been to Lubber Run, and only the first time Manny's played with us, so... We've been.
Woo! Manny.
It's been fabulous to play. If you've been to our shows before, you see we do an awful lot of French and Brazilian and Spanish music. And we've been to Lubber Run for a few years and we thought, let's do something totally different. And that's what was behind creating this show for you, especially tonight. So it's just been gorgeous to hear you singing and to see the place fall. We are going to finish the evening with another Carole King song, made famous in 1967, but still on the Tapestry album. And it was made famous by the Queen of Soul. We want you to get your soul on.
Yes.
This is the summer of soul right here in Arlington right now. Woo! Yeah. Let's go gospel on this one. We do have CDs to sell at the end of the show. You'd be very welcome to join us. But meanwhile, we're going to get our soul on
Let's
with you.
Let's do
right
it.
Now. Take us to church,
Amy. I'm looking out on the morning rain. Wow. I used to feel so uninspired when I knew I had to face another day. Lord, it made me feel so tired before the day I met you. Life was so unkind, but you're the key. I didn't know just what was wrong with me till your kiss helped me name it. Now I'm no longer that fool.
Sure.
Made us feel wonderful. Thank you so much.